What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. And today, I am a bit upset, to be honest with you. This month is Black History Month, right? And Black History Month usually talks about, well, it talks about the contributions of African Americans in, well, normally, you learn in school about the historical contributions of African Americans in America. You know, that's cool. You know, you learn about your Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Harriet Tubman, Frederick Douglass, you know, the Mount Rushmore of Black History Month, right? But while that is good, it's also, well, not the people, but just that particular, you know, that little small little bite-sized part of our history is always told. And it's upsetting because rarely, if ever, do we get to really delve into the full significance of Blacks in America and in the world. And that's what I want to call that the miseducation of Black history. Now, people who are familiar with that phrase know exactly what I just did. The miseducation of Black history. I made that statement because, for those who don't know, Black History Month was started by a Black man named Carter G. Woodson. But when he started, it was called Black History Week. He proposed a week where, you know, we reflect on our historical relevance, you know, in society. And it transformed into Black History Month. And he also wrote a book called The Miseducation of the Negro. That's why I said The Miseducation of Black History. And I said Miseducation of Black History because for as long as I can remember, since I was in school, every time we spoke about Black history in school, we always started with from slavery to the present day, right? It was always slavery to present day. It was always, you know, Harriet Tubman, you know, Martin Luther King, Sojourner Truth, Frederick Douglass. That was always the narrative. It was always from slavery to the present day, which is fine because you should know about that. You should know about what happened to you. There's an expression they say, slavery isn't a part of Black history. Slavery interrupted Black history. Black history was stopped when slavery happened, right? But what bothered me then, and it bothers me now when I see the generation of today come up in school, is that when it comes to Black history, we hardly ever talk about the contributions that we made to the world prior to slavery. Black History Month always wants to start with slavery up until today. But we hardly ever talk about what we did before slavery happened, before the transatlantic slave trade happened. We hardly ever talk about history then. So I want to dive into that a little bit. First of all, I want to know, why is that? Why is it that? Because I'm trying to think. Since I was in school, elementary school, junior high, high school, there was never that talk of pre-slavery, pre-transatlantic slave trade and talked about in school. Only time we talked about that was in history class. And that was either ancient Egypt, which they just brushed over that. They just talked about how big the pyramids were, but they never really talked about the contributions as a whole to ancient Egypt. We spoke about Columbus and Isabel and Ferdinand of Spain, but we hardly ever spoke about the Moors that ruled Spain from 711 to 1492, that gave Europe the wealth of knowledge and riches that it has to this very day. the reason why Europe is a power that it is to this very day is because of the Moors. Hollywood, we don't talk about them. And when you do see the Moors, I remember being in school and seeing images of the Moors, and they were light skinned. Even in the books of during that time in elementary school, that was always the case. We spoke about ancient Egypt. In elementary school, I never had a history book in elementary school where it spoke about, you know, Egypt being a very dark land. It was always light skin. We spoke about Cleopatra and all that stuff, but that was it. We hardly ever spoke about Cleopatra. We never spoke about the ruling families in ancient Egypt, like Hatshepsut, which was, people call her Queen Hatshepsut, which is no. That's also miseducation. Part of the miseducation was we got our history through the lens of someone else. We never got black history through the lens of black eyes, of an African paradigm. It was always African history through a European paradigm. Whenever we talked about ancient Africa, it was always through the lens of a European eyes. I've never spoken about the Dogon in elementary school when it comes to black history. Never spoke about the word Dogon didn't even come up. We never spoke about King Mansa Musa I of the Mali Empire. Never spoke about that. We never spoke about Shaka Zulu. We never spoke about Shaka Zulu on Black History Month in school. Never. As far as I know. And I know they don't talk about Shaka Zulu now. Anything about, if people say, well, you know, that was over in Africa, that was over in Europe. Well, what about over here? Well, what about over here? Like, because as far as I know, I can't think of any moment in time when I was in school, elementary school, junior high, where we spoke about the Haitian Revolution. I can't think of it. All the history classes that I had in elementary school, junior high, and high school, I can't think of not one time. I can't think of one time where we spoke about the Haitian Revolution. And Dessalines and L'Ouverture and no. No. The only time you would get that kind of information, that real information, is if you had a teacher that went rogue from the book and then broke that down. But in terms of a curriculum about what the teacher was supposed to teach when it came to certain topics and subjects, no. Never talked about that. And the thing is, why is that? Now, I know the reason why, and I'm pretty sure you know the reason why. But what bothers me the most, what bothers me is that it's still going on. That the educational system still feels comfortable in speaking about Black History Month in a very small window. And that window is from slavery till today. And it's maddening to me. It's upsetting. I'm thinking about if all you give children about their history, if all you give a child about their history is from the time they were oppressed to this very day, and every story is a sad story. Africans were stolen from their land, they took their names taken away, their religion taken away, you know, their way of life taken away, they had no rights, they were property, they were less than animals, they were property, they were sold off, and then you go from that to Jim Crow, we had legalized segregation and whites and coloreds and all that stuff. And you go from Jim Crow to civil rights, we had Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Medgar Evers, and they were shot. All of your civil rights leaders were shot, were set up, were framed, all of that. Martin Luther King, shot. Medgar Evers, shot. Malcolm X, shot. Then you talk about now. What about the time in which kids are living now? You have Freddie Gray, Trayvon Martin, all these things. This gets put into the Black History group. When kids are taught Black History on February in school today, all you hear about is shot, stolen, slavery, shot, lynched, burnt, shot, bombing, shot, set up, all that. It's all you hear. And no one, and when you indoctrinate children so much, the child never grows up thinking about, wait a minute. Was there ever a time in Black history where we weren't oppressed? Kids have been indoctrinated so bad that kids don't even bother to ask that question nowadays. I'm like, okay, does our history start off with slavery and then up until today? Was there more to our history in Black history? Well, we had plenty of inventors who had this stuff stolen. All of the Black inventors that you hardly ever hear about either had this stuff stolen or they died poor. You hardly ever hear about a triumphant story that ends in triumph when it comes to Black history. All of the great things we did usually ends up tragic when it comes to the Black history that we are taught in schools. Like I said, all of the inventors, most of them died poor. The musicians, most of them died poor. Even if they invented something, died poor. All of our civil rights leaders, most of them died poor or were killed. Like, what is? Do we ever get a chance to be educated about history, our history, in a triumphant way? Or is it always, we were stolen from somewhere, brought somewhere else, kidnapped, sold off, chained up, freed, but not freed, segregated against, miseducated, set up, assassinated, lynched, burned, Emmett Till, no justice. Is it always like that when it comes to what we talk? When you think about what children are taught in Black history, a lot of the Black history stories never end well. We talk about how great the great things we've done, but the story never ends well. Why is that? And then when you constantly get that from generation, like I got that in elementary school. I just wanted the outlier children that happened to say, okay, what were we doing before we were enslaved? Before slavery, before the transatlantic slave trade, what were we doing? How were we living? Did we ever die in greatness? We lived in greatness, but did we ever die in greatness? Why are we never taught about the things that we did, and when we died in greatness? And when we do talk about things that we did, that when we died in greatness, we never attach that to Black History Month. In the school system, we never attach the Moors to Black history, where somebody can say, okay, this is also a part of your history. We never attach ancient Egypt to Black history, where the teachers can say, this is also Black history. We never attach the Haitian Revolution to Black history in schools. This is the miseducation of Black history to our children, where the children will grow up not being able to associate themselves with greatness and being able to live and die in great greatness. Like, that has to stop. It has to stop with the schools. It also has to stop with the parents. As we grow old and we have children, we have to teach our children that, look, this part right here, this 400, 500 year window is an extremely small part to the vast lineage of our Black history. Because if you want to talk about Black history is far longer than 400, 500 years. 400, 500 years is a blip in our vast history. that we hardly ever talk about in schools. So my message is, parents, teachers, be bold enough to teach your children the full scope of Black history. Because Black history is way longer than a month. So we have to be brave enough to teach the full scope of Black history. Black history is, there will be no American history without Black history. There will be no world history. Black history is world history. You take away Black history, you have no world history. None. In no continent on the planet, if you took away Black history, you would have no world history. All right? So be bold and be brave to teach that in schools and stop with the miseducation of Black history. Okay? Catch y'all later. Peace.